Hi you guys, and welcome to my channel. Yes, Miss Ferris. I know it's been a long time, but I'm back, y'all. And today I came on camera looking crazy because it is a wash day. And during this wash day, I'm going to be using the Sauce Beauty products, and I'm going to be doing a product review on the line. So Sauce Beauty is a line that's inspired by like food products. So and it's a natural hair business, and it's inspired by, like I said, food products. And so the names of the different products I'm going to be using are like food related, so that's what kind of brought me to choosing this line and seeing. I have seen some reviews by people that I follow already online about them using the products, and it's had pretty mixed reviews, I would say. But I'm gonna be giving y'all my take on it and what I think about the line of products and how they work with my 4B 4C hair. So the products that I'm gonna be using from the line are four different products. I purchased their moisturizing shampoo. It's called the Island Marinade, and it's Jara Honey and Jamaican Black Castor Oil are, I guess, the base ingredients of this product. I purchased the moisturizing conditioner, which is called the Creamy House Dressing. Buttermilk, Greek yogurt, and shea butter are the ingredients in this one. I purchased the leave-in conditioner and detangler. It is called the Tzatziki Taming Spray, and its active ingredients are the cucumber water, yogurt, and coconut oil. And last but not least, I purchased the Deep Moisture Mask. It is called Guacamole Whip, and its active ingredients is avocado, argan oil, and monoi oil. And I'm gonna use it as a deep conditioner, so it's called a deep moisture mask, so it's like a mask, I'm assuming, and I'm gonna be using it as a deep conditioner on my hair. So I did not purchase every single product from that line, but I tried to hit most of the bases as far as like a shampoo, a conditioner, a leave-in, and a deep conditioner. Let's talk price point. So I got everything from Sally Beauty. I got everything from my local Sally's, and each product cost me $10.39. Like in-store, walking in-store, it cost me $10.39, so I got all four of the products for $45.72, including tax. I'm reading right off my receipt. So, and I purchased everything myself, obviously. And so, $45.72 for four products is not bad for me, you guys. I usually spend around $40 on two products, depending on the brand in which I'm purchasing. So, $40 to $45 for four products was not bad for me. Especially when I'm talking about spending around $10 on each product, and you all don't have to buy everything together. So running at around $10 per product is not a bad price point for me. Each product is, the shampoo and the conditioner I bought was 10 fluid ounces. The leave-in conditioner was 8 fluid ounces. Yeah, 8 fluid ounces, and it has like a spray top. And then the deep conditioner was 12 fluid ounces. So 12 fluid ounces for $10 is not bad for me when I think about it. I did see that each product is, if you purchase it online from Sally's or directly from the Sauce Beauty website, they run at $9.99. And I mean, people coupon and everything else. So you literally will get it for right around $10 per product. And for me, that's not that bad. So I will be washing my hair off camera. Like, as far as shampooing it, I'm gonna be washing it off camera because I don't have a shower mirror, so it's kind of hard for me to do it on camera. But as far as the conditioning and the deep conditioning, you all will be able to see me do that on camera. Okay, you guys, so I'm back and I have just shampooed my hair. I used the moisturizing shampoo and that's it. I didn't get very far, but this is how my hair looks just after shampooing. Which to me, y'all probably wasn't checking for. If you already is washing on curly hair, then you're not checking for heat damage. Me, I just came out of a blowout, so I was like checking on heat damage too. And it's a plus that I don't see any. So yes. But other than that, this is how my hair looks. It does not feel stripped at all. And I shampooed it twice. And, you know, thinking like maybe, you know, I didn't get it all the first time. But no, my hair feels really moisturized for me to have just used a shampoo. And I mean, I guess that's why it's called moisturizing shampoo, because my hair really does feel so moisturized. At the ends, from root to tip, it just feels really good. I haven't detangled yet, so y'all don't judge me. I just wanted to come and show y'all how my hair looks right after shampoo. So, okay, you guys, my hair is split into four sections just for me putting in the conditioner. I'm going to be re-wetting my hair with aloe vera juice, which I use in my spray bottle most of the time, like interchangeably with water. Since my hair's already had water, I'm gonna be using my aloe vera juice to keep that moisture process going. So, and it's in chunky parts. Usually I do six parts, but I'm just putting on conditioner, so it's just four chunky parts. I'm not really picky about it. Sorry, my computer's in the way. My hair just dries so fast. The consistency. And I'm just putting it on, y'all. No certain kind of way, no super purpose. Just putting it on. I make sure I focus on my ends, though, in the end. I just got a trim when I got my blowout, so my ends shouldn't be looking too bad. By it being so thick, I feel like it's requiring a little bit more product than if it was something looser, but I ain't tripping.
Just a girl, you were just a boy. Together we were one. Together we were perfect. Talk about in sync. You know what I'm thinking. Before I could even think it, get out my head. I was just a girl.
back, you guys. I just rinsed out the conditioner, the rinse out one, not the deep conditioner. And this is my hair after. Y'all, it feels so good. The slip is insane. Like, my hair feels so soft, and it's like actually slippery. And I've rinsed it a couple of times, so I know it's not like products alone, but. And you see the curls are like more defined now. So I'm like almost feeling like I don't even need the deep conditioner, but I'm gonna deep condition anyway because I need all the moisture I can get. But yeah, those curls are like defining and shrinking up. Like, look at this. Look at that. So I'm gonna get to the deep conditioner and I will be back, you guys.
I was just a girl, you were just a boy. Together we were one. Together we were perfect. Talk about in sync. You know what I'm thinking. Before I could even think it, get out my head. I was just a girl, and you were just a boy. Two ordinary people made extraordinary love. Extraordinary love. I was just a girl, you were just a boy.
You guys, so this is the next day and this is how my hair looks. I did a twist out, like I said, using the leave-in conditioner, and then I used some grapeseed oil, avocado oil, and then one of my other butters that I usually use for a twist out, just doing the, well, the lock method, but LCO method. So this is how it came out. It is fluffy, it is light, and my hair feels moisturized. But let's get into these products and the breakdown of how I like them. So, oh, and one thing I realized earlier in the video is I did not give you guys the ingredients. So I will give the ingredients on, or the main ingredients, I guess, on each of the products as I review them. So, and girl, I have to write this down because each one like has different things going on with it. So let's start with the shampoo. So the moisturizing shampoo, the ingredients start with water, sodium is next, olefin sulfonate is next, jar of honey is like the seventh ingredient, and then it goes to the macadamia seed oil, argan oil, castor seed oil, aloe, leaf juice, corn kernel, wheat flour, soybean seed, and a bunch of other things, which I kind of expect in a shampoo because it's to clean your hair. So any cleaning agent I kind of don't think of as being so like all natural. But I did go online to thesoftbeauty.com and seen that this one, the shampoo, is alcohol free, paraben free, silicone free, and sulfate free. So that is up there on the website, and if you go to the website, it will break down the ingredients, even the ones that's like hard to pronounce, and tell you exactly why it's in that product and what it actually does. So instead of me, because I'm not a scientist and I can't pronounce half these words, instead of me breaking it down, you can just go on softbeauty.com, click on the product, and then it'll give you a breakdown of the ingredients so that you know what's going in your head. But okay, let's get to the review. So as far as me, what I would give it from on a scale of like, girl, no, to yes, Yes, I can't even deal. I need this in my life. I would give it a... I would give it about a 4. I would give it a 4. So, as far as cleaning my hair, it did. I felt like my scalp actually got cleaned and it did not strip my hair, which I like the feeling. Do I think it's not a clarifying shampoo. So it's not even that I think. Like, it's not a clarifying shampoo, but it gets the job done in between those washes where I need a clarifying shampoo. I'm not super product heavy on my hair, so I don't clarify a lot. So if I do need a clarifying, I'll go get one. But other than that, this does the job really good as far as just getting that dirt out of your scalp so that your scalp can breathe. So it does its job. I give it a 4 on a scale of 1 to 5. I give it a 4, and I would definitely buy it again. And look how little I use, you guys. And I shampooed my hair twice. It lathers really good. I shampooed my hair twice and I still have more than half the bottle left, like a good 3/4 of the bottle left. So this will give me a couple uses out of it. So I'm giving it a 4. So we can move on to the moisturizing conditioner now. As you can see, like, I used a bit more of this than the shampoo, and y'all, this was my favorite product out of all 4 of the products. I loved this conditioner. It acts kind of as a deep conditioner to me, more so than even the mask. It's so creamy, so it's a little bit hard to get on your hair if your hair is not super soaking wet, but it's doable and you can get it on your hair. It's not like you're doing too much work to do it. You'll probably see in the video I was like banging the bottle like come out because it is so thick. So I noticed that, but I mean, for a good product, I don't care. Like, for a good product, I don't care. So on a scale of 1 to 5, I would definitely give this a 5, you guys. For a rinse out conditioner that the directions only state to leave on for 3 minutes, it is very moisturizing. It does exactly what it says it's gonna do, and I like this better than the deep moisture mask, to be honest. So I give this a 5. I would definitely repurchase this again, and it does not, like, I mean, it helps that the smell is just so, it smells so good. So, ingredients wise, this one is alcohol-free, silicone-free, gluten-free, sulfate-free, and paraben-free. So this one, if that's what you look for in one of your conditioners, then it hits all those marks. I'll read the main ingredients. Is water is the first one. Cetearyl alcohol is the second one. And I know I say it's alcohol-free, but cetearyl alcohol, some people don't count it because it's not a drying alcohol. It's actually a fatty alcohol. So people don't really count it as an alcohol, but I guess if you want to, you can. Shea butter is the 5th ingredient. Buttermilk powder is the 6th. Greek yogurt powder. Malic acid. And then a bunch of words I can't pronounce. Again, you can go to the website and it literally has it all listed. From the looks of it, when I looked, it looks like it's a bunch of them are like emollients and things that give your hair a slip. So it wasn't anything that was like, yikes, I'm putting this in my head. So there's that. We can move on next to the deep moisture mask. This one I liked, but the fact that I used it after the moisturizing conditioner kind of paled in comparison to it. On a scale of 1 to 5, I would give it a 3.5. It is moisturizing. It is moisturizing. But the moisturizing conditioner actually defined my curls more. And so then after I put this on, my curls somehow weren't as defined as they were a step earlier, which kind of made me mad a little bit, because it helps for my hair to already be sort of defined when I style it, so that my twist outs can come out good, or if I'm doing like a wash and go. My wash and goes definitely it helps with those. It's like a step I feel like I could have skipped, when I am definitely like a deep conditioner girl. So for me to even say that I felt like I could have skipped this step kind of shows. And I've only seen good reviews about this, so maybe I'm crazy. Y'all tell me if I'm crazy. But after using the rinse out conditioner, the moisturizing conditioner, I wasn't that impressed with the deep moisture mask. But it still was good. That's what I'm saying. Like, it wasn't like, terrible, bad. But just using it after that, it's like, well, I could have just stuck with that conditioner. So, this one, as far as ingredients go, y'all wrote everything down. But as far as ingredients go, it is alcohol-free, salt-free, gluten-free, sulfate-free, and paraben-free, according to the website. A couple of the ingredients. Water is the first one. Glycerin is the second one. Dimethicone is the third one, which my hair, for some reason, loves dimethicone. So I thought it would really be, like, something super spectacular. But, I don't know. Honey, jar of honey is like the eighth ingredient, and avocado oil, argan kernel oil, gardenia flower extract, coconut oil, castor seed oil, and yeah, so there's that one. So I gave that one a 3.5. and last but not least, oh, would I repurchase the mask? Probably not. I just get the conditioner, the moisturizing conditioner, honestly, because I mean, for price point, maybe. Like, for price point, if I just was like out of coin for some reason, and I'm like, I can't afford my TGIN deep conditioner this week, so I just need something quick, fast, I'd repurchase it, because it is only $10 as compared to like $17.99 for my TGIN, girl. But it had to be that predicament in order for me to rebuy it. But still, like, a fair product. It's fair. It's just meh. It's fair. Last but not least, this leave-in conditioner and detangler. I like it. I like it. It is, it made my wash and go. It made my twist out very fluffy, but still feel moisturized. And again, I didn't use it like alone by itself, but I use my other butter all the time. I use the Soul Tentacles, Can't Believe It's Not Butter. I use that all the time, and I kind of mix it with other things, so I know how it feels with other things, and it actually paired pretty well with this one. Again, it gave me a nice fluffy twist out, and it feels moisturized, so it does what it says it's gonna do. Do I believe that it can be used as just a detangler on like some dry hair? No, I don't. It took quite a bit of this, if you all can't tell from the bottle. It took quite a bit of this to get done with the twist out throughout my whole head. And this spray bottle sucks for this product. It sucks because it puts out short little spurts, and when you have longer hair, you need more. So you just pumping, 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 and getting out these little spurts. And the product, it's like, it's runny, but it's still like a pretty thick consistency for a leave-in. So it's runny enough that it can get through the squirts, but it's just small little squirts, and it sucks when you have longer hair and you need to get through the whole shaft. It smells great. All of the products, if I didn't mention it before, smell edible, but they give a disclaimer on the package: do not eat, it's for your hair. So I wouldn't eat it, but they all smell edible. But this one is just a lot of work. It's a lot of work. So on a scale of 1 to 5, I'd give it a four. I'd give it a four because I like how my twist out turned out. It's a little bit more frizzy, which this is supposed to be like a taming spray too. But it's a little bit more frizzy, but that could just be because I separated like a lot, because I wanted it to look like second day hair rather than first day hair. But so it got the job done. Would I buy it again? You know what, I'm gonna give it a 3.5 for the simple fact that I don't know if I'd repurchase this again. It's too much work, and for it to be the last step in your day is too much work. I do want to use it again, but I want to use it on a wash and go, because I actually think it'll work good on a wash and go. I think it'll pair good because it is moisturizing, and that's what a lot of wash and goes miss, is being moisturized. So I want to try it with a wash and go before I can give a definite if I'll purchase it again or not. So you guys, I hope I did not do a bunch of like rambling that you guys don't care about on the end of this video. I just tried to hit some of every point because I am doing 4 products. As far as the Sauce Beauty line, if these is 4 of their products, and I believe they only have like 3 others. They have an oil, they have another shampoo, they have a thermal heat spray, and another conditioner. So that's 4 other products. Then half of their line is, it's good. So Sauce Beauty, I would say check them out, y'all. They, as far as price point, they are affordable. They're not one of the ones that's charging $20 a product. So and all these products I purchased with my own money, so no, this is not sponsored. They are not paying me to say this. I just genuinely like the line. So yeah, if you have any questions, you can put it down in the comments. Again, y'all, like, comment, subscribe, talk to me. I'm always here. No, I don't always post, but I am always here, and I'm always checking. I am getting better about posting, or I'm trying to get better about posting more videos. But yeah, interact with me, like, comment, subscribe. I'm here. If you want to share the video, you can do that too. So until next time, thank y'all so much for those who subscribe or those who just took the time to watch the video or whatever. Like, thank you guys so much. Love you so much. See you in the next video. Bye.